problems and do a geometry problem before we call it a day. So let's just look at the first example on the next section, 9.2, okay? If each side of a square is increased by 3 units, the area of the resulting square will be 9 square units more than twice the area of the original square. Find the side of the original square, all right? So for geometry problems, the representation actually is going to be a little bit different. Instead of just saying let x be whatever, okay? But you can still say it, let x be what? What are we looking for here?
Square.
It's not, what about the square we're looking for?
Side.
Actually, strictly speaking, I should have said maybe find the length of the side, right? Okay? Find the side, so meaning I want to know how long it is, okay? But what comes to mind here, when you read this problem, you see square, square, square. So you have a picture of a square. So draw the square. Assume that's a square, okay? We want to find the side of this square. So that side is what?
X.
X. Now what else is happening in the story here?
Three,
what did
added
I do
to
with
that?
This? The side of the square increased by 3, okay? So I don't think that's good, but it's you understand what I'm saying? The square became bigger, so therefore, instead of just x, I have what for the side? I have x plus 3. So this is what you do for geometry when you represent, is you kind of like draw pictures to tell you the story, okay?
Oh, okay.
So we have x became x plus 3. How many letters did we use? Just one, so therefore, how many equations do we need?
One.
So let me write it here, sorry, I made the other way. Okay, let's do Chinese stuff. All right, okay. So then we go that way. So how do we find that equation? Okay, where's the equal sign in the sentence?
Will be.
Which side, blah, 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 will be, right? Okay. So we have, will be is the equal sign. So we have a left and a right. What is going to be on the left side? If each side of a square is increased by 3, we already used that here, right? Okay? So the left side really is what? Area of the resulting. The area of the resulting, that really has something to do, is it the original or the new square? The new square, right? Okay? So this is the area of the new square. So this is the area of the one with x plus 3 for the side, right? You understand? How do you find the area of this new square? What is the formula for area? What do you do with the side?
The base and the...
Wait, no base.
Length times
what? You have a square, side is S. What is the formula for the area for a square?
It's S squared.
S times S is side squared, right? So side squared, so therefore the area of this resulting square is what? X plus 3, the quantity?
Squared.
Is that clear? Okay. So that's your left side over here, x plus 3, the quantity squared, okay? So that's your left, now that's the right. 9 square units, do you understand why I have to use square units? Because it's area, right? 9 square units more than, so this is really just going to be 9, right? More than what? More than is what? What symbol do I use for more than?
Plus.
Twice. Is 2 times something. 2 times what? The area of the original square. The area of the original square. Original square is the smaller guy, right?
2x squared.
X, yeah, it's x squared, right? The area of this is x squared, correct? Okay? So it's 2x squared. So it's going to be, let me see, help me. That's going to be 9 plus 2x squared. Did you understand that? Okay, and do we know how to solve this?
Yes.
Can we call it a day?
Yes.
Bro, what do we do?
What do we do?
First.
Open this up, right?
Yes.
And then you can move stuff around. You know what to do, right? Okay, you know how to solve. Okay? Thank you, guys.